whispers among the heavens and the earth. The ever-living, he is the first. He's the owner of mercy. He sent his messengers.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, most merciful, I greet you all, my dear audience, in our Islamic way. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, mercy, and blessings be with you all. In the previous episode, we mentioned that the glorious Quran recorded the word earth in more than 462 places. Every notion of this word earth is actually a scientific precedence that testifies for the divine nature of the glorious Quran and for the correct prophethood of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. We also mentioned that the glorious Quran speaks about the cosmos in two words, heaven and earth, or heavens and earth. And we also mentioned that the word heaven came in the singular form 120 times, and in the plural form 190 times. And this is an indirect indication to the fact that Allah initially created one firmament, then he split this one firmament into seven firmaments. And these firmaments are enveloping each other. The word tabaqan does not mean horizontal layers one above the other, but it means spheres enveloping each other. So we have seven firmaments in the form of seven magnificent spheres enveloping each other. And in the center of these seven firmaments, we have the earth, a tiny little spot in the exact center of the seven firmaments. And this tiny little spot that, of course, cannot be related to the great dimensions of the firmaments, contains within it the seven earths. And modern researches in the area of seismology has indicated that the interior structure of our planet is mainly composed of seven distinctive spheres around its own center. The inner core, the outer core, the lower mantle, the middle mantle, the upper mantle, the subcrust, and the outermost crust. We are living on the first earth, and we have six earths below our own feet. And Mecca is exactly at the center of the first earth, the first continental masses, land masses. It's the distance from the farthest extremities of the seven known continents is exactly equal, 13,600 kilometers. And he, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is also quoted to have said that the Kaaba of the angels is in the seventh firmament above our Kaaba in Mecca, exactly, so much so that if it were to fall, it would fall immediately on top of it. This means that the Kaaba, our Kaaba in Mecca, is exactly lying on the axis of the universe. Seven firmaments, seven spheres enveloping each other, having the earth exactly at its center. This tiny little spot is including within it the seven earths. Mecca is at the center of the... Modern astronomers used to defy the multiplicity of the universe. They used to talk about universe. Uni means one, and verse means sky. And so they used to speak about one sky, one firmament. But through very complex recent calculations, they came to realize that actually there are seven distinctive firmaments. But they consider them to be seven disks, one above the other, and they assume that we are living in the uppermost one of the experiments, which is a completely wrong description and completely wrong assumption. It does not have any base whatsoever other than the number. Also, astronomers started by believing in a geocentric universe, having the Earth exactly at its center, and they came to deny this and assume that our solar system is not at the center of our galaxy, so we may not be at the center of the universe. But both the glorious Quran and the teachings of Muhammad, peace be upon him, emphasize the central position of the Earth with respect to the universe. So mentioning the Earth in 462 verses in the Quran and in many, many sayings of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, indicates that there is a specific importance to that planet. And the specific importance is that it's a central position with respect to the universe, which man can never decide through his limited vision and limited faculties, limited senses, limited tools. Yet, whenever the astronomers try to portray the universe or the observed part of the universe, they put the Earth at its apex. A segment like this, having the Earth at its apex. But the Quran and the Sunnah emphasize the central position of the Earth with respect to the universe. And the Quran being the word of the Creator, it has to be absolutely correct. We finished the last episode by a verse in the Quran, which reads, وَفِي الْأَرْضِ آيَاتٌ لِلْمُوقِنِينَ, and in the earth are definite signs for true believers. So the more you look into the earth, and the more you look into the universe, you can see many signs of the Creator, many signs of His wisdom, His knowledge, His might, the perfection of everything He has created. And for the Quran to say, وَفِي الْأَرْضِ آيَاتٌ لِلْمُوقِنِينَ, in the earth are definite signs for those who truly believe, encourages us to look into what are these multiple signs that can testify to the fact that the earth is a living example, a living testimony for the oneness of the Creator, the great might, knowledge, and wisdom of that Creator. One of these aspects is what we call earthquakes. Earthquake is a very devastating phenomenon that takes place every now and then. And the Quran has mentioned earthquakes in several of its verses. It speaks about earthquakes of this life, and then it speaks about earthquakes at the moment of destruction of our universe. And in between, the Quran speaks about earthquakes as a means of testing to humanity. And we read in the Quran, in Surah An-Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 26, the Quran reads, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قَدْ مَكَرَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَأَتَى اللَّهُ بُنْيَانَهُمْ مِنَ الْقَوَاعِدِ فَخَرَّ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّقْفُ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ وَأَتَاهُمُ الْعَذَابُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. And the translation goes as follows, those that were before them did plot against the divine guidance. Then Allah struck their buildings from its foundations, and the roof then fell down on top of them, and the chastisement came upon them from whence they cannot perceive. Also, we read in the same chapter, Surah An-Nahl, verses 45 and 46, the Quran reads, أَفَأَمِنَ الَّذِينَ مَكْرُوا سَيِّئَاتٍ أَنْ يَخْسِفَ اللَّهُ بِهُمُ الْأَرْضَ أَوْ يَأْتِيَهُمُ الْعَذَابُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ أَوْ يَأْخُذَهُمْ فِي تَقَلُّبِهِمْ فَمَا هُمْ بِمُعْجِزِينَ أَوْ يَأْخُذَهُمْ عَلَى تَخَوُّفٍ فَإِنَّ رَبَّكُمْ لَرَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Do they feel secure, those who devise evil deeds, that Allah will not cause the earth to be deeply rifted by them, or that the chastisement would not come upon them from whence they are not aware of? And these two verses actually emphasize the fact that earthquakes are a sort of punishment from the Creator to ill-doers. And in Surah Al-A'raf, we also read, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وكم من قرية أهلكناها فجاءها بأسنا بياتا أو هم قائلون فما كان دعواهم إذ جاءهم بأسنا إلا أن قالوا إنا كنا ظالمين فلنسألن الذين أرسل إليهم ولنسألن المرسلين. How many towns have been destroyed for their sins? Our punishment took them on a sudden by night or while they were sleeping for their afternoon rest. When thus our punishment took them, no cry did they utter, but this indeed we did wrong. Then shall we question those to whom our message was sent and those by whom we sent it? I'll read the translation again. How many towns have we destroyed for their sinful actions or for their sins? Our punishment took them on a sudden by night or while they were asleep for their afternoon rest. When thus our punishment took them, no cry did they utter, but this indeed we did wrong. Then shall we question those to whom our message was sent and those by whom we sent it down? In Surah Al-A'raf also we read a similar verse, but I think we are coming towards a short break. And until then, I thank you for listening and greet you in our Islamic way. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, mercy and blessings be with you all. Coming back from this short break, I greet you, my dear audience, once more in our Islamic way. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, mercy and blessings be with you all. We were talking about a number of Quranic verses that speak about worldly earthquakes. And we could see clearly that earthquakes are a form of punishment by Allah to ill-doers. We mentioned a few verses and we have two more verses. We have in Surah Al-A'raf, chapter number 7, verse number 96 to 100, the Quran reads, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَى آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَكِنْ كَذَّبُوا فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. أَفَأَمِنَ أَهْلُ الْقُرَى أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا بَيَاتًا وَهُمْ نَائِمُونَ أَوْ أَمِنَ أَهْلُ الْقُرَى أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا ضُحًى وَهُمْ يَلْعَبُونَ أَفَأَمِنُوا مَكْرَ اللَّهِ فَلَا يَأْمَنُ مَكْرَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. If the people of the towns had but believed and feared Allah and heeded Allah, we should indeed have opened out to them all kinds of blessings from heaven and from earth. But they rejected the truth and we brought them to a book for their misdeeds. Did the people of the town feel secure against the coming of our wrath by night while they were asleep? Else did they feel secure against its coming in broad daylight while they played about caring free? Did they then feel secure against the plan of Allah? But no one can feel secure from the plan of Allah except those doomed to ruin. The last verse that speaks about this life's earthquakes reads, comes in Surah Al-Mulk, chapter number 67, verse number 16. And the Quran reads, أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ أَنْ يَخْسِفَ بِكُمُ الْأَرْضَ فَإِذَا هِيَ تَمُورُ. Do you feel secure that he who is in the heaven will not cause you to be swallowed up by the earth when it shakes as in an earthquake? And I presented these verses because many of the people of our time, Muslims and non-Muslim alike, actually try to speak about the earthquakes as a physical phenomenon that has nothing to deal with punishment from the Creator. But the Quran, the word of the Creator, emphatically states that earthquakes are a form of punishment to ill-doers. And actually, earthquakes are among the most grievous disasters that can take place on the surface of our planet. And the Quran also tells us that earthquakes can come to good Muslims, to good believers, as a form of testing, because these opposers to the fact that earthquakes are a way of punishment from Allah say, well, if this is a way of punishment, many good believers are taken by earthquakes. Many young children are taken by earthquakes. How come it becomes a punishment for ill-doers? So the Quran tells us in Surah Al-Baqarah, second chapter of the Quran, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُلْزِلُوا حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهِ أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ. Or do you think that you shall enter the paradise without such trials as came to those who passed away before you? They encountered suffering and adversity and were so shaken in spirit that even the messenger and those who believed in his message who were with him cried, when will come the help of Allah, the victory from Allah? Ah, verily, the victory of Allah is always near. So despite the fact that many innocent people can be taken by these earthquakes and many are saved, this does not defy the fact that earthquakes are actually a means of punishment for ill-doers by the divine decree. In Surah Al-Ahzab, the Quran reads, هُنَالِكَ ابْتُلِيَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَزُلْزِلُوا زِلْزَالًا شَدِيدًا. In that situation, where the believers tried, they were shaken as by a tremendous shaking. So the shaking, including earthquakes, including illnesses, including war, all these can be means of testing human beings. The Quran also speaks about the final earthquake that will destroy everything on the surface of our planet. In Surah Al-Hajj, the Quran reads, chapter number 22, verse number 1, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. O mankind, heed your Lord. Verily, the earthquake of the last hour will indeed be a terrible event or a terrible thing. In Surah Al-Zalzala, and this is the whole chapter of the Quran, although small, but yet it speaks about earthquakes and mainly about the final earthquake by which our planet will be completely destroyed. And the chapter reads, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَلَهَا. When the earth is shaken by its final quake. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. And the earth has brought forth its burdens, its heavy loads. يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. Upon that day, it shall tell her chronicles, her news, her history. بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا. Upon that day, it shall tell her chronicles because your Lord has inspired it to do so. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَصْدُرُ النَّاسُ أَشْتَاتًا لِيُرَوْا أَعْمَالَهُمْ. That day, mankind will issue forth in scattered groups to be shown their own deeds. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. And whosoever does an atom's weight of good will see it then. And whoso does an atom's weight of ill will see it then. So this final destruction, of course, will be much, much greater than everyday earthquakes, which are among the most severe events that can take place on the surface of our planet, because an earthquake can happen in a few seconds and can take tens of thousands of souls, if not more, and can injure multiples of that figure, and can actually make homeless tens of folds of that figure, and can cause material destruction of several hundreds of billions of dollars. So really, earthquakes are among the most damaging events that can take place on the surface of our planet. And in the traditions of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, we read that he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, woke up one day with a red head and image of great distress. And he used to say, La ilaha illallah, there is no deity except Allah. وَيْلٌ لِلْعَرَبْ مِنْ شَرٍ قَدْ اِقْتَرَبْ. Woe to the Arabs from an evil that has drawn near. فُتِحَ لِيَأْجُوجُ وَمَأْجُوجُ مِثْلُ هَذِهِ. And small opening from the wall of Ya'juj and Ma'juj, Gog and Magog, was opened today, and he made so with his fingers. And then Hadrat Aisha, Umm al-Mu'neen, she said, O Messenger of Allah, أَنَهْلَكُ وَفِينَ الصَّالِحُونَ. Are we to perish while we have many pious people amidst us? He answered, نعم إذا كثر الخبث. Yes, if bad deeds are in abundance. So people who try to object to the reality that earthquakes are among the tools of punishment by Allah to ill-doers can listen to this saying by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Because their main argument is that how come you say that this is a punishment for ill-doers while many, many innocent young children are devastated by these earthquakes? The Prophet said, yes, if ill deeds are in abundance, then the punishment will come. And people with good deeds or innocent individuals that would be taken in that event will be resurrected according to their own beliefs, and they will be amply rewarded by Allah. Glory be to him. Similarly, in Al-Bukhari, Hadrat Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, is quoted to have said, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is reported to have said, لا تقوم الساعة, the last hour will not come. Hatta, and he mentioned many events and came to the end of his saying by adding, وَحَتَّى يُقْبَضَ الْعِلْمِ, the true knowledge will be withheld. I'll stop here because I think our time is over, and we'll continue discussing earthquakes in the glorious Quran and in the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the coming episode. And until we meet, I thank you for listening and greet you in our Islamic way. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, mercy, and blessings be with you all.